Okay, so here is my patch with the marrow border, and I'm gonna just show you what I have on my screen. This is the edge setting. I have it positioned, top stitch, add light fill, and I changed the density to 6. It was originally 8. I wanted it to be just a little bit more filled. To get to this setting, you have to go to a shape, any shape, whatever shape you want. And I just made this shape around the design I wanted. So you make your shape. I add a stitch to it, but you probably don't have to. And until you push, this adds the stitch. Of course, this is way too small, so let me zoom out and make it bigger. So. So this is what it does whenever you first make it. It says cut with complete. I believe that means you just put your fabric down, you make your marrow border, then you cut out your patch. I don't typically do that, so I can use pre-cut where I just lay the fabric down and it just does the marrow border around my fabric, no fill stitches. You can hand cut it in the hoop where it gives you a this extra line here, so it has the position, and then it stitches your fabric down, then you cut around this inner stitch, and then it will start to do the marrow border. Let's go back to the stitch artist function, go back to the edge function options, and then you have using a fill. I believe this is if you're not using any type of fabric, because it makes a really dense mesh underneath the fill stitch, so it's more like an all stitch patch. And the last option is a light fill. So this is what I used for my patch over here, and what it is I put a fabric down, and this will stitch out. Let's go to the run. So it's going to stitch the light fill and then continue with the marrow border. This is with the density 8. That's the way it comes default, but I changed it to 6 on mine. I hope this helps with the settings. If you have any comments, please let me know. But thank you for watching.